Hi everyone, I hope you enjoyed that wonderful demonstration. This particular demonstration is called the magnesium dry ice. And so before I talk about what you just seen, I want to first discuss the safeties and the hazards that come from this particular experiment. Namely, for safety, you'll need a lab coat with, in this case, flame resistance. So usually those are the blue colored lab coats. Then you will need safety glasses or goggles, but in this case you need those that are like considered the torch goggles or torch glasses, and those have like permanent shades on them. And then cowl gloves, which are the blue fabric ones. And so the reasons for that is because of the hazards. So first is the dry ice. Dry ice sublimes at about negative 78 degrees Celsius. So in this case it's very frigid temperatures, and because of that, prolonged exposure by touching with bare hands or bare skin, you have frostbite. But then if you were to put a patch of dry ice into a closed container, you would have pent up pressure over time, and that will cause an explosion. Then for magnesium is flammable, and once it starts burning, it'll burn up to greater temperatures of 3000 degrees Celsius, and it also emits light and UV light. So keeping that in mind, we want to then kind of go into what is happening in that particular experiment. So what we have is that we have magnesium metal and we have oxygen. When you introduce to heat, you have a reaction that is spontaneous combustion, and you'll have magnesium oxide forming along with heat and light, which is a form of energy. And so as you saw when I had put the second block of dry ice over the reaction, you saw that it still kept reacting. And the reason for that is because for class A fires, in this case for like wood or paper, you can use fire extinguisher that has purely carbon dioxide and the fire we put out. But in this case, because there was a lot of carbon dioxide, especially dry ice, the magnesium kept burning. And that's because magnesium will reduce carbon dioxide into carbon and oxygen, which is the fuel needed to keep burning. So that particular reaction or combustion will continue to react until all the magnesium is used up and transformed into magnesium oxide. So for those kind of fires, you need a class D fire extinguisher, which is specific to those that are metals that are undergoing combustion. And so I hope you keep that in mind when you're doing this experiment. And I hope you have a wonderful day. Thank you.